Thank you very much, Professor Riambau. I would like to again thank the Professor Hosni and all the organizers for the kind invitation for me to be here today, sharing our experience. And it's somehow a case a little bit similar to the one that Professor Riambau presented in terms of the complex part was the one that went badly. So it's which one? Here. Okay, so these are my disclosures, and I would like to show you this slide. This slide is a slide from my talk in this place in Cairo 1 year ago, talking about the complex auto-iliac aneurysm and the hypogastric preservation. And if I focus on two of my conclusions for that talk, first of all, I said that hypogastric preservation should be mandatory, and then I presented an option with the core IBE that is a more flexible system to treat the complex auto-iliac procedures. So this is one of the problems, and following that idea I showed here 1 year ago, we look at this case. It was a 77 years old lady, COPD, with a 5.6 aneurysm, bilateral small iliac aneurysms with a pretty long infrarenal neck, very good but angulated, and a severe elongation of both iliacs with kinks and tortuosity, but good hypogastric landing and iliac access looked okay. So following that idea, we did the sizing planning for this complex case, like doing a bilateral IBE to preserve both hypogastrics with both IBEs from GORE and the main body, a C3 from the right axis for the main body, and then bridge extension to fix the IBEs, the iliac branch with the main body. We thought it was a smart approach, but we were prepared for a difficult day at the OR because of that extreme tortuosity of the iliacs and the hypogastrics. So we went there and we did the first the right, as in the planning, and then the ballooning, and then looked good, and the control for the right iliac branch looked good, and then we went to the left, and as you can see, it was really tortuous. This is a Landquist wire that is totally bent by the bend, so even with the through and through, we weren't able to correct the position of the iliac branch. But we did it. We got the cannulation, it was fine, so then moved to the next step, that is the simple step. We did the difficult one, we did the right and left IBE, and then the easy one, that is the C3 main body. So we went here, and something strange happened when we opened the graft. This is after opening, you see the graft is here. It's not perpendicular at all to the renal, came down, isn't a strange image on the screen. So this is a repositionable graft. I thought it moved down, then I close it, go up again, open again, and then it's even worse and much more strange. Came down more, the graft is lower, malpositioned, and the wire is outside the aorta. So this is nothing very good, doesn't look good. And I came back to the image before the opening the graph, and I realized that I was wrong from the very beginning. The wire was outside the aortic lumen before opening the graph, as you can see. This is the lumen, this is the wire outside, and the graph was deployed outside the aortic lumen in a dissection that we performed with the wire. So now what can we do? Because we have an open graft, two IBEs that were really complex to perform. We have both bilateral axes. One is inside the aorta, the other is outside. But thanks God, the pigtail is still in the true lumen. So we change the pigtail for a stiff wire and go up with a new main body, new one, and trying to find the correction of the position in the infrarenal aspect. But then I realized that with the rush of the moment, the C3 main body we had in our stock was too long for this case. So I couldn't use that main body. And if we were discussing about money, that was a really expensive try with the C3 main body going up and going out because it was impossible to use it. And then change, oh, again, thanks God, we have another consignment stock from Cook. so changed to a short 70 millimeters Zenit Alpha that was deployed now inside the aorta, that's the proper position, and was gently advanced and deployed. As you can see here the Alpha is deployed, and here you can see the C3 that was deployed outside the aorta. So well, the first C3 was abandoned inside the sac, and then I cannulated and bridge stent that were deployed sequentially, preserving the right IBE in the good position. And in the end, problem, because this is a complex case, it's a disaster case, in the battle we lost the left renal. So after, I would say, more than 20 minutes fighting with that renal, we were able finally to deploy a chimney graft into the renal, and the final round looked quite decent. The final round was good, chimney patent, IBS patent, no flow apparently to the dissected space, and a C3 abandoned into the sac that is somehow of EMBO-EVAR technique, expensive one. So, well, was not that bad, but remember that this is a disaster case. So 48 hours, the patient had an acute pain at the ICU. We did a CT scan and we found this. A dissection, retrograde dissection, coming from the visceral part of the aorta, going up, and okay, both IVs were patent and good. Chimney renal looked good, was patent, the kidney was good, and we did a very nice retrograde dissection. So at that time, I thought, what can I do now? I have this, but it's much better to stay calm, wait and see. And could this be the abandoned C3, some kind of candy plug? Again, a very expensive one. Well, could be, that was my hope. But again, remember, this is a disaster case. And in the follow-up, 3 months follow-up, we found an increase in diameter of the thoracic aspect of the aorta. 8 millimeters in 2 months. That is too much, with both lumens patent and a really bad appearance of the whole thing. So we decided to go with the stage approach, thinking that we probably need a full metal jacket repair of this patient. So we did the thoracic graft. Here you can see, and this was in July 2019. This is the last follow-up I have for this patient, waiting for December 2019 follow-up. And it didn't look very bad. As you can see, thoracic graft looks okay. Renal chimney looks okay. IBE, both IBE patent. And if I can compare that region post-TIVAR between the first CT scan and 1 year post-TIVAR, thoracic diameter still stable. So, look very decent, but again, we have two problems. The first of all, I have just partial thrombosis of the false lumen, despite the good looking, and unfortunately, we have growing of the AAA sac infrarenal. So this was the last CT scan in July, and this is my question to all the audience. What shall I do? What do you think I need to do with this patient to present for next 2020 IMAC? Probably stay like it is and wait and see, or go for a full metal jacket with any of these possibilities. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Emil.